constellations, asterisms, and the constant march of time. When we look up at the night sky, we see myriads of stars. Sometimes we can recognize patterns. Other times it looks like a connect-the-dots diagram. From the earliest of times, cultures defined the skies above them, created unique groupings of stars, and named them according to what they saw. Early Chinese dynasties saw a very different sky than the Mayans. The Aboriginal people in the Southern Hemisphere didn't even see the same sky as those in the North. As one can imagine, this could create much confusion when trying to describe portions of the sky to someone else. In 1922, in an effort to unify the skies around us, the International Astronomical Union formally accepted the modern list of 88 constellations and, in 1928, adopted the official constellation boundaries that together cover the entire celestial sphere. This way, when you ask someone to look at the constellation Orion, everyone would be looking at the same portion of the sky, no matter where they lived on Earth. Sizes of constellations are all very different. Hydra, the largest constellation, takes up about 1,300 square degrees in the sky. Triangulum, by comparison, is tiny, taking up only 130 square degrees. Out of the 88 constellations, 36 are mostly in the northern sky, while 52 are mostly in the southern. Some constellations, like Orion the Hunter, are easily recognizable. Sometimes, however, you will need to use your imagination when looking at star patterns. For example, Canis Minor, the little dog, looks more like a hot dog than a real tiny terrier. Within constellation boundaries, there are familiar groupings of stars known as asterisms. One of the most famous asterisms is the Big Dipper, which lies within the constellation of Ursa Major, the Great Bear. The asterism of the Little Dipper lies within the constellation of Ursa Minor, the Little Bear. Most asterisms lie completely within one constellation. However, the asterism of the Summer Triangle spans three constellations, Lyra, Cygnus, and Aquila. Inside the Summer Triangle is yet another asterism known as the Northern Cross. If you go out tonight and look to the north, you will see the Big Dipper, Little Dipper, and Cassiopeia. The star Polaris is nearest to our north celestial pole, the point in the sky about which all the stars seen from the northern hemisphere seem to rotate. We refer to Polaris as our north star since it is so close to the north celestial pole. However, Polaris hasn't always been our north star. As we go back in time, you can see how the location of the Earth's north celestial pole has changed, forming a large circle, until it comes back to center on Polaris. What causes this circular motion, which astronomers call precession? The gravitational pull of the moon and sun cause the Earth's axis to wobble, much like a spinning top that is almost falling over. One full cycle takes about 26,000 years to complete and causes the star nearest our north celestial pole to change over time. Come back in another 12,000 years, and Vega, in the constellation Lyra, one of the stars in the Summer Triangle asterism, will be our North Star. Don't feel bad for Polaris, though, because in 26,000 more years, it will once again be the North Star.